Hey guys, how you all doing? Really? That's just great. You know, I'm doing confused. Moments before I was about to document this tech video log for you, someone contacted me with a very similar problem. So now it's like we got two issues going on at once. But basically, an operating system will not install on this computer, even with a different hard drive in it. So what's up? I'm not quite sure. You and I are gonna take a look. Let's go. So no tech video log would be complete without a tragic backstory. Here's the situation. Someone I know has this MacBook Pro and they needed to reinstall the operating system. I believe they tried to install El Capitan, but it would not install. However, this was the other odd thing. I got that other MacBook Pro, I think it's the same model as this one, if not very similar, which also had a problem with El Capitan being installed. I don't have it with me right now because I had to return it to the owner, but here was the series of unfortunate events that followed. So I downloaded a copy of the El Capitan installer directly from the App Store, booted into it, and the install started. Then it said, OS X could not be installed on your computer. No packages were eligible for install. Contact the software manufacturer for assistance. Okay, well, Apple, you would be the software manufacturer. Last I checked, you made Mac OS. Good job. Of course, it got stuck in a boot loop. It would kernel panic on every startup, and just automatically reboot after about 5 seconds. So I hit up the Google machine, and I Googled that top error message, OS X couldn't be installed on this computer with the package thing, whatever. And the top results all had to do with El Capitan, so I was like, what? El Capitan must just have this issue. Could it have been fixed? Sure, some articles said you have to adjust the computer's date and time or whatever. That's all fine and dandy. I'm sure you guys have other great solutions too, but for all intents and purposes, just to save time while we all live on this rock flying through space, I installed a newer version of the operating system, High Sierra. I went to my buddy DOS Dude, downloaded a High Sierra patcher. I didn't use the patcher, I just used the little tool button that let me download the official installer from Apple servers for High Sierra. Then I entered in the terminal command to create bootable media and threw that installer onto a flash drive. Plugged it into the computer, ran the installation, and then I got the Ghostbuster symbol. And then it rebooted later, and it like continued installing, and then it beeped at me. It gave a long beeping noise, thought that was really weird, and then it showed a different type of progress bar. I kind of forgot what that meant, but I think it means it's doing some sort of repair startup or something like that. Anyway, it ended up working after just automatically failing and rebooting a couple times, so everything is all good. So I figured if we had luck just by using Colin's awesome shortcuts with that computer, perhaps we'll have the same luck with this computer, but we like to tinker and experiment on the show and do process of elimination. So before we just jump to the easy answer, let's actually see if we can recreate the problem that my buddy was having. So let's power her up. And it looks like we just have a recovery partition right now, 10.11.6. Makes sense. Let's boot into there. So far, so good. Just a random sheet floating out in the nether. Just, you know, why not? Continue. A required download is missing. What the sh** does that mean? Well, I can't say I've ever seen that before. Command option R for internet recovery. Let's see if that makes a difference. Now, while that's loading up, I'm gonna do a little digging, because I kinda wanna know why this is happening. Okay, so another solution I did find was something I believe the owner of this already tried. We created an El Capitan installer, specifically on this flash drive, and it still didn't work. That's really weird. So, I'm taking his word for it, we're ruling this out. So that means the recovery mode reinstall is failing. The flash drive we made with the terminal command, same operating system, is also failing. So our last hope for El Capitan that I can think of off the top of my head, three strikes and we're out, is doing internet recovery and see if that even works. And someone said, oh man, I faced trouble in creating the El Capitan USB and then I found a link to buy the USB. So someone was making El Capitan installers and apparently selling them on Amazon. Tap the link, of course the page is gone now. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's illegal. Oh, internet recovery defaulted to High Sierra. I guess Apple heard our woes and just sent the magical pixie dust down to fix our problem. All right, we have the drive, which we'll convert to APFS. All right, guess we'll check back in soon. I was chatting with some community members on our Computer Clan Discord server, and one of them suggested a similar thing with the date and time. Maybe that would work, but Sage also mentioned that some installers, to put it bluntly, might just be expired, and there are ways to download DMGs directly from Apple's website for those older installers. So yeah, whether or not that might have worked, I'm not sure yet. Maybe I'll tinker with that later, but so far it looks like High Sierra is going to work just fine. So thank you everyone for your suggestions in the Discord, and if you haven't joined the Discord yet, definitely grab a link and join. Here we go. Okay, well, that's it. So the good news is that solution worked. The bad news is that was way too easy, and I need more. So here's what we're gonna do. I went to the official Apple El Capitan download website that Sage pointed out to me, and I downloaded the DMG file to put on this flash drive. Just keep in mind, it actually downloads a DMG with a package file inside of it. You have to run the package, it puts an application in your apps folder, and then you have to use the terminal to create the bootable media from that application. Anyway, little weird, but it worked. So now we're gonna see if this particular version of El Capitan installs. The other weird thing is, I have another El Capitan installer that I actually got from DasDude's website, and it worked on my 2013 MacBook Pro, but when I loaned that to this owner, they said it didn't work. So it worked on a machine that was 2 years newer than this one, but not on this one? That's weird. Don't know why that would make a difference, but I wasn't in his presence when he tried that out, so maybe I just need to test that myself later. But for now, let's try this official one from Apple's website. So far, we're getting way further than we did get with the recovery mode at the beginning of the tech video log. Both were El Capitan installers, both from Apple, but for some reason this one is working better? If anyone can explain that sorcery, do let me know in the comments. Okay, we have confirmation that this El Capitan installer works fine. Okay, so now on the flash drive, we have the copy of the installer that is archived on DasDude's website. Not a patcher, and it wasn't the download that was built into the patcher, it was just directly from one of his archives. We'll erase the hard drive, and install. 0 seconds remaining, and we're rebooting. And as I expected, this one is working fine too. Very interesting. The whole reason the owner gave me this computer was because he couldn't get El Cap installed. I even loaned him the flash drive with the El Cap installer on it, and he said it didn't work. Do you know what we call that? We call that user error. Or maybe it's just miscommunication. But I'm just glad we were able to narrow down the problem more. So, I'm gonna let this finish to- Oh sh**! What? Oh, what? I spoke too soon! Oh, come on! Okay, well, people might call me crazy. I mean, it's in my name. But what the hell? How come one OS X El Capitan installer works, but the other one, same version number of the installer application, by the way, doesn't work? And even weirder, why doesn't it work on this particular machine? I can vouch for DasDude that the El Cap installer he has on his website worked on my 2013 MacBook Pro, no problem. But it won't work on this one, I think it's a 2011. What? So just for grins and giggles, I plugged in DasDude's archived installer again, and I went to the terminal inside of the installer and set the clock back 2 years just to test that theory. The clock was set, and it installed just fine. So, I guess we narrowed that down now too. If you're having a problem with those required downloads, and you're using an older OS on an older computer, I guess just set the clock back a little bit, and everything's good to go. So, we got that down. I'll put High Sierra back on here just to have a newer system on here for the owner. But really, the ultimate lesson we learned today was to search for the why. Because if you know what the problem is, you could probably fix the problem. But if you know why the problem happens, you can prevent the problem in the future. Use that if you want to. That's my advice for the day. I'm just glad we got it working. Thanks for sticking with me. Catch the crazy and pass it on.